water's cold this morning, Captain.
Cold and wet.
Great Scott!
Yes?
What's that? He looks like a cruise liner, Captain.
Sir, we've got you. Where's your ship?
Whoa. Whatever happened, it's giving them the willies.
Get this man some medical attention.
That won't be necessary.
What? Who are you?
Captain DeSoto is an employee of the Dolan Corporation. We'll take care of him from here.
Okay. We'll start a search for more life rafts. Just tell us, how many passengers want this missing cruise liner?
Who said anything about a cruise liner?
A lost captain, but no lost ship? That's mighty suspicious. We're in the Coast Guard. We ought to do something.
My hands are tied. I really gotta get the hang of these sailing nuts. But I do have a connection. Who could look into this?
Who are you gonna call?
Hello, Button on McGee's desk. This is Mango speaking. Who may I say is calling? What? Hold on. My Bigfoot? Tell me, is your feet really that big?
Investigators, what are you doing at my desk?
Oh, Butternut. I was just going over your security protocols. You heard the dog burglar and Mash who escaped recently.
Forget that, Brash. I'm wondering why he's getting calls from Bigfoot.
Give me that. Who is this? Oh. Mango, this isn't Bigfoot. This is my brother-in-law, Scott Squash.
Oh. That is his Sasquatch?
Uh-huh. Got it. The Coast Guard rescued a cruise ship captain not far offshore, but the cruise line says no ship has gone missing.
How does one lose a cruise?
Investigators. World famous cupcake chef Gustavo Mustachio has gone missing.
Wait, I know this one. Gustavo fell down a manhole and was kidnapped by Crocodile.
Do we go through a time loop, General Inspector? That case was 6 books ago.
Wait, no, wrong mission. Gustavo is just one of 500 passengers on a cruise liner that's lost at sea.
So there is a missing ship.
500 passengers? Then why single out Chef Gustavo?
Well, considering your past history with Gustavo, I thought it might help get you emotionally invested in the case.
We're professionals. We get invests for every mystery we face.
Boss, we just heard about the ship from the Coast Guard, Gorg. How did you find out?
There's a press conference about it going on right now.
We at the Dolas Corporation would like to announce a promotional event in support of our recent dive into the cruise line.
Let me interrupt you right there. Hi, CC Bourne Stories, Action News Now. Do you care to address the rumors that one of your cruise ships has gone missing?
It's not missing. The sea dude isn't scheduled to return for another week. It can't be missing if it's not supposed to be here.
Then why was its captain just found floating in a life raft?
Captain DeSoto just came back because he, forgot to feed his cat Willy. It'll be shit safe to captain the sea dudes the second when it set sails tomorrow.
His cat?
You're letting his cat captain the cruise ship?
No, DeSoto will captain the cruise ship.
Dang it! I put on the sausage for nothing!
So you're saying that the passengers on that cruise don't need saving? You expect us to buy that?
Everyone, please trust me. You know that I, Bill and Dollars, am all about savings. Savings that I pass on to you, the consumer, by my way of Dollars Discount Trademark Stores. And in that tradition, I'm officially announcing the Dollar Cruise. Anyone can experience an all-exclusive adventure on board a state-of-the-art ship for just $1. Start it right now.
$1?
Now that I'll buy.
It's enough of a deal to make anyone forget the fact that you won't tell us what happened to the last cruise.
I'm no longer wondering why no one's heard from the passengers on that ship.
Naturally. And would you want to be disturbed on your vacation? Of course not.
He's got a good point, and an even better price. I deserve some time off.
Me too.
This all seems fishy. At the start of Gustavo's trip, he was posting a picture of a daily cupcake. But look, he hasn't updated in 3 days.
You follow him on social media?
What? I just like looking at pictures of sweets, okay? Mango and Brash, your mission is to find that ship, and more importantly, all the passengers.
We're on the case!
Something went wrong on that first cruise, and Bill and Dallas is trying to cover it up with another cruise.
Come on, Mago. Let's flush our way into that billionaire's guarded tower and see if we can find out where he's hiding.
To the sewer.
You still there, Scott? Yeah, they usually take off without saying goodbye. I'm so used to it, you know. Anyway, how's your mom?
Now, which sewer line will take us closest to Bill and Dallas's office?
My money's on that one over there.
Ah, more like his money's on it. Figures someone worth a fortune would have gold-plated, Plummy.
Hey, these pots are silky smooth. Wow, that was nice. A gator to get used to traveling in a style like this.
No one's here. Good. There's gotta be details about this first cruise somewhere. Mango, go be lookout while I search Bill's office.
Got it. Well, this certainly is a long hallway. These must be Bill and Dawes's grandparents and great-grandparents and great-great-great...
Miscellaneous paperwork. What have we got here? The Dallas Company only acquired this cruise line a couple months ago. Was it a lousy investment? Are the ships faulty?
This family fortune goes way back. Hey, Brash, did you know long before this was the Dallas Company, the family name...
Who are you?
Who, me? I'm an adventurer.
An investor? You're not on the schedule, but I suppose I could spare a minute for those looking to contribute to the dollar's bottom line.
Right, let me distract you with some meandering questions such as, what does the N stand for?
Oh, the N is for the brand recognition. Going by Bill and Dallas is one of his billion-dollar marketing ideas, like his Dallas discount stores.
Shouldn't that be the Dallas discount stores?
Well, yes, but there was already a vampire rapper who trademarked the name Discount.
Yo, 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 this is DJ Discount. Come here, you undead from Nautila. Where's my double is at?
Was there anything else?
I'd just say, look forward to shaking Bill's hand when he walks through those doors.
That will never happen.
What? He's not much of a handshaker?
Not that. He won't walk through those doors. Mr. Dallas has a private elevator that leads directly to his office.
Was this list? Gustavio Mustachio? Oh, this must be the passenger manifest from the first cruise. Wonder if any of these bananes will ring a bell.
Dang! But don't you see, Mother? That proves it's true. And this next cruise won't settle all our debts. Oh, don't be so dramatic. They're a dime a dozen. Or in this case, a dollar a pop. Either way, it's like I've always said, even bad publicity can be monetized. I'm going on this cruise myself to ensure these sunk costs turn a profit. I may not be the one who found our family fortune, Ma, but I still won't be the one to lose it. Smidlap, Here's the passenger manifest from the first cruise. Make sure the numbers add up. Take all this nonsense to the boat and prepare a cabin for me.
Sir, are you sure you want to go through?
Yes, I've only got till the end of the week to fulfill the terms of this deal or I'll lose everything. I'll be ruined.
Oh, sir, there's an investor here.
Who? Where?
He was just here. A little green guy. All right, that's it. Come out of there. This isn't a public restroom.
Are you seeing ghosts too, Schmidlap?
Brash, I learned about branding and vampires. What did you find out?
I learned that Bill and Dallas isn't making any dollars from these cruises.
Bill's already worth $1 billion. Maybe he's happy with what he has.
He didn't sound happy. Bill said he'd go on the next cruise himself to make sure it's profitable.
If Bill knew something bad did happen to the Sea Dunes, how would going on the Sea Dunes the second be the smartest move to keep his company afloat?
What could be worth risking even more passengers' lives as well as his own?
Maybe the first ship found buried treasure. Or Bill wants to perform the selfless act of saving the passengers personally.
That's preposterous, especially the latter.
This latter?
Our best bet to find out what happened on the first ship is to get on that second ship.
Me! I better pack my swell trunks.
Yeah, we'll want to pack plenty of luggage.
Then let's go see Seven Septipus back at Soup to gear up.
Mango, why are you going up the wrong ladder? HQ is this way.
What? But you said...
Come on!
Ah, Gators! Sea Or was just telling me that you're taking the cruise.
Not just taking the cruise, Seven. We're investigating where a cruise was taken.
We're trying to figure it out if the Sea Dunes went off course, or sank, or was hijacked.
Or hit an iceberg.
It's a tropical cruise, Mado.
Or got lost in the Bermuda Triangle.
It's pronounced Bermuda.
Or discovered the lost city of Atlanta.
That's Atlantis.
Or there were mutants on board.
You mean mutiny at board.
That's what I said.
The point is, Seven, we don't know what twists and turns this trip will have in store for us.
So break out your best boating vests.
These are the current trend in yacht fashion. A blend of nautical nylon, seaworthy silk, and recycled water bottles. Lightweight, though. Also a little light on features.
That's a star. But to navigate whatever troubled waters we may find ourselves in, we need more exciting spy technology.
We got a messed up. Diamond gear sailed universe or boards hard pulls wet seas water skis water bows fishing tackle flip boss lead stuff beach boss on spit cool shades and of course bringer quids the man in fine glass all weekend you know look for clothes and stuff.
That's a long list. It'll take me all night to get this stuff together for you.
We'll take these while you burn the midnight oil. The Sea Duels the second leaps first thing in the morning.
Ha. Huh. I had a cousin who worked in the cruise industry.
I'm sorry for your loss, Seven.
No. We just lost touch. Ever since the day I lost my sense of touch in this tentacle.
Then I'm sorry for the loss of your tentacle, then.
Thanks, Mago.
You should take me on the mission.
That won't be necessary, Sea Or.
Aww.
Why? Since you're a butler, you can make sure all of our luggage gets to the docks.
Don't even think about flushing these designer bags down the toilet. Have a nice trip.
You tell.
The next morning.
I like big boats and I cannot lie.
Mango, it's a ship.
Nice that for once we can dress casual for a mission.
Sea Orm should be here somewhere with our luggage.
Found it. But where's Sea Orm?
We need that robot's help to get all these bags on board. Sea Orm? Sea Orm?
Pass. passengers are limited to one carry-on and one personal item.
What? Oh, great. I guess take this one, and I'll take these two. Remind me to text C-Or to come back for the rest.
I sure hope security doesn't make me take my shoes off.
First of all, Mango, they only do that in airports. And second of all, you don't even wear shoes.
Hey, you know how hard it is to find a size 5.5 wide? Sheesh. Aw, look at you, so cute. Although poop in a porter outfit.
Two for the cruise, please.
Two tickets, $2.
All I got are lint and mismatched buttons. Brash?
Give me a sec.
$2 cash.
Hey, what's the hold? Let's get this show on the road. The water.
I want my $2!
Okay, quit pounding me!
Okay, well, we got all together. This makes, 87 cents? Wait, Mango, what's that?
This is my bath full of corners.
Mango, just buy the tickets with dolls.
But I need these for laundry.
Here, keep the change.
But one of them doesn't not pay.
Mr. Dallas, with the first sea doing still somewhere at the sea without its captain, people are saying that you had little regard for the welfare of others. How can you reassure everyone that the sea dooms the second is safe?
It's perfectly safe. If it wasn't, would I be going on this cruise myself? I have total confidence in Captain DeSoto and the Sea Dooms the Second's new cruise crew, too. You said how many of the crew quit, Schmidtmap?
About 8 or 9, sir.
So long as there are enough passengers for, you know. Now step off so I can get on board without having to mingle with the other com owners.
Welcome aboard to the Sea Dooms the Second. The state-of-the-art cruise liner has enough lifeboats, life desks, life rafts, life preservers, and life coaches to save everyone aboard from any crisis, existential or otherwise.
Well, I feel safe. How about you?
I'll feel safe once I know the passengers who are on the first Sea Dooms were safe.
Find this way to your quarters.
Oh, good. I'd like to give back some change.
She means our cabin, Mango.
Aw, man. Whoa. The motion of the ocean takes some getting used to.
You gotta get your sea legs. Me? I only have sea legs. Here you are. Should you mean anything? I'm the ship's bosun, Bjorn.
Bjorn? Say, you wouldn't happen to have a cousin named Seven, would you?
Selen? That name no longer has any meaning to me.
Oh boy, doesn't take a detective to tell this in history here.
Seven's cousin on our cruise? What are the odds?
100% apparently.
That's not how math works, Mango.
Hey, this isn't too shabby for a dollar.
Yeah, I don't see how Bill and Dallas will make a profit on this cruise, but he did say it will
settle all debts.
Leave the unpacking for later, Mango. Let's go buy some cruise clues.
Hello? Temp agency? Yes, I'm gonna need more freelancers.
Where's that passenger manifest? I need to double check that there are at least 500 souls aboard.
Brash, did you hear that? Bill and Dawes is collecting souls.
Souls is a term for counting people on board a vessel, Mango. Dawes just wants to know how many tickets he sold.
Really? It sounds omnibus.
Mago, an omnibus is a collection of written works. Ominous means a foreboding evil.
Foreboding evil? I'm not convinced Dallas isn't boding for evil.
Are you two crocodiles lost? This deck is for crew only.
We're not crocs. We don't worry neither.
Investors? You must be who talked to Schmidlap. You should have warned you not to, never mind.
Well, we have a, business proposition, if you're interested.
Our interest alone could be enough to buy the ship.
We want to chat with Captain DeSoto about what it's like working for your company before we invest.
We are very picky about our vests.
So sorry, DeSoto can't be disturbed. He's too busy captaining the ship. Now why don't you go enjoy some of the Sea Dunes the Second's many amenities?
Manatees? Oh, I've never met a manatee.
Make sure no one else tries to get onto the bridge, Petty Officer Whiskers.
Petty Officer? I thought the job description said Tenting Officer. Can I at least get some beer scritches?
Oh, alright, try.
Dallas is clearly afraid of whatever DeSoto could tell us, even if it means passing up a business deal.
We'll uncover the truth one way or another.
We are undercover agents after all.
Normally I'd suggest we go incognito as part of the crew, but there is hardly any.
Crew uniforms, we will only draw more attention.
Look, Bajoran's even pulling double duty as a lifeguard.
The ship certainly is short-staffed.
Eh, the cat seemed pretty average height to me.
Few employees means Dallas will have a low overhead, but being thrifty isn't criminal.
An awe-inclusive trip for just a dollar is quite a steal, though. Hey, maybe Houdino's here. He won't pass up a steal and he can't pass up a deal.
Nah, it's too soon for a low-tier villain like Houdino to make another appearance. But that does raise a good question. What if who was on that first cruise is a clue to whatever happened to it?
And what if who is on this cruise is also a clue?
We know Chef Mustachio was on the previous cruise, but we don't know who...
I know who, Brash.
Don't say crocodile.
It was...
Mango, the last time I saw my former partner, Daryl, he was a radioactive goo that dissolved into the ocean and or evaporated into a mist. I'm still a little unclear on the spiffix.
Exactly. And if somehow he was still out here, he'd be looking for a way to be
back into a cracker? Really? After all the closure we had?
Muck, there's the head scientist from the science factory.
It's nice to get out every once in a while and feel the sun on my lap coat.
Think about it, Brash. With the combined skills of a baker and a scientist, I just find a way to come back to life.
That wasn't even as far a bore! No, Mango, you sound like me. You're letting my imagination get the best of us.
Eh, you're right. There's no evidence that makes that old saltine to any of this.
Hey, I'm finally at the point where I don't freeze at the mere mention of a big good. Look, we mustn't go overboard with far-out theories. And speaking of baked goods, we can't keep looking for clues on an empty stomach.
Then let's see what kind of brought this all-inclusive cruisers.
What if the Liz wafer... to come back?
Aww, there is an arcade. And they've got Superpower Punch at the third Turbo Deluxe Dance Edition.
Here's the restaurant. Looks like it's self-serve.
Oh, a buffet. Our options are cheese sandwich or double cheese sandwich.
Yeesh, I guess our $2 went entirely to our quarters.
You know, for $2, we should get 8 quarters.
There's gotta be something better in the galley. Come on.
Huh, you call this a galley? Where's the ark?
Mango, that's a gallery. The galley is the ship's kitchen. Huh, doesn't seem like there's enough food in here to last the full trip.
Can I help? Oh, it's you.
Sure? Again?
Weren't you just outside working as a lifeguard? How many jobs do you have on this boat?
I've got 8 jobs, but I'm still paid like 1 employee. In case you haven't noticed, the ship's got a skeleton crew.
Skeletons? Spooky.
Who exactly are you two?
He's Mango. I'm Brash. We're investigating what happened on the first sea dunes. Do you know-
Okay, listen. One job I'm not paid to do on this boat is stick my nose into other people's business. I went a long time ago to look out for numero uno, number one. And also numeros dos through ocho, numbers 2 through 8.
This is about your cousin 7, isn't it?
I don't know. We had a bit of a falling off.
Don't you mean falling out?
No, I mean falling off. As in, when our arms fell off. 7 and I grew up together. As kids, we played claw control at the playground.
This one is Scuttle. She's the firefighter.
One time, while seahorsing around on the sea monkey bars, a bully tried to take 7's action figure. When you're caught between an eel and a toy he wants to steal...
That's a meringue.
Hey, get that back!
I could have let 7 fight his own battle, but I stepped in, and things got out of hand. Literally. At first, we laughed it off as no big deal, because squid and octopus tentacles grow back. Except, for some reason, 7's didn't. 7 blamed me for it. All I did was help him. I got back his toy, but I was the bad guy? I got grounded, and his parents wouldn't let us play together anymore. That taught me that even doing the right thing will land me in trouble. These days, I avoid trouble and land. So if you're looking for someone to lend a hand, you've come to the wrong cephalopod.
7 may owe you an apology, Ushorn. But one day you'll regret hoarding this grudge for so long. Make no bones about it.
Is that a squid joke? You know squids don't have bones, right?
Hang on. Ocean's 8 poems. I just got that.
We've been pacing up and down this deck all night and haven't made any progress since the ship left port.
Port? This case is too important to give up now, Brash.
I'm too tired for jokes, Mango.
I'm not joking. In fact, I'm done kidding around. Okay, that one was a joke, but I meant it. Follow me.
I get it, DeSoto. You're scared, but not as scared as I am that will happen in 2 days if... You again? You're not investors. That was all a crock.
Close. We're investigators.
And we want the truth. Did the first sea dunes crash, sink, capsize, tsunami, iceberg, leak, aliens, squall, Loch Ness Monster?
And why does Cappy DeSoto still have the willies?
Is Willy Nilly a who? A what? A where?
A werewolf?
Mango!
What? Bajoran said there were skeletons on board.
Ghost!
A ghost? Could he have seen... Daryl! Ghost?
Oh, so now you believe it's...
Well, it makes more sense than a werewolf.
Well, which is it? Ghost or pirate?
He means corporate piracy. I run a billion-dollar corporation, you see, and DeSoto fell overboard on off the last cruise. News of that would sink my business and leave me open to a hostile takeover by a rival company. Yeah, that's the ticket. And if people didn't buy tickets, I'd really be up a creek.
This ship is no riverboat. It wouldn't fit up a creek.
Mango, make sure DeSoto doesn't go overboard again. You brought DeSoto on this first cruise to pretend he was fine, but how can the first Sea Deuce be fine without its captain? And who is actually captaining this ship?
I'm a captain. A captain of industry. Captaining is in my blood. Besides, everything is automated these days.
DeSoto? Hey, have you seen Captain DeSoto?
No. Have you seen a red dot?
Me? Oh, no. Never. DeSoto? Captain? Ew, what's with this fog?
Glowing green mist? Could it be? Dallas, reverse throttle before the ship hits something.
Not before I hit pay dirt.
Mango! Captain DeSoto did see the ghost of... Daryl! That's what... No. Who willy-nilly is? He's... Willy-nilly!
That doesn't really fit the naming convention. Daryl! Used for all his evil incarnations, Brash.
Look!
This ship and all aboard now belong to the dread pirate ghost, Willy Nilly.
Who's Willy Nilly?
Me! I'm Willy Nilly! Yarr! Say hello to the salty piranha!
Take no prisoners! Take everyone prisoner!
Yum!
Bow!
Stool!
Okay, so it's not...
But it is totally pirates!
You have your orders, Mr. Edmund.
McLuggan, was it? Group those passengers together. You there, Sullivan?
I'm Gilbert. He's Sullivan.
And I'm Caught Little Buttercup.
Never mind the why and wherefore. Lock all the passengers' scum and door cabins.
Yeah!
Blar.
I knew it! The legend is true! Where's that passenger manifest? I have to count it again one last time. Let's see, 490, carry the one.
Mr. Dollars, there's no sign of Captain DeSoto, or that red dot either.
Dang it, Whiskers, no, I lost count.
More of you lily-livered man lovers.
What do you call a man lover? I'm an alligator, I'm ambiguous, I mean, amphibious.
Stowing you, and stowing you.
This isn't even our cabin.
The packing is like sardines.
Hey!
No offense. This is certainly more than anyone bargained for.
Yeah, for $1, who knew this trip would have so much excitement?
We gotta figure out a way to stop those sea thieves.
How? There's so many of them.
We could foil whatever their plan is from within if we go undercover as part of their crew.
Push. Not in these outfits. We need the secret agent gear in our cabin, but we're trapped.
You two are secret agents?
Shh. We're secret agents.
We're gonna die!
Calm down. This is no time to lose your head. It's time to use your head.
That's it, Mango. We'll use the head to get to our cabin.
I am using my head, Brash. I'm thinking as hard as I can.
Mango, the head is what a toilet on a ship is called.
Ah, I see where you're going with this. Anchors away!
Yeesh! I do not want to see where they're going with that.
You there! Find Edmund and round up the crew!
Our crew?
Nay, the crew's crew.
Want me to wrestle my...
What? No! I want every soul on the ship accounted for, even if they have to be an employee or employer!
Arrrrrs!
I think that's the exact number. Mads never was my subject. But I won't risk it coming up short and being one among the doomed. Well, it is the captain's duty to go down with the ship.
That's very noble, sir.
You got that promotion after all, Captain Whiskers.
Look at me! Look at me! I'm the captain now!
That's right. You go down with the ship.
Wait, what?
Enjoy captaining the sea thing that's a while it lasts. Rest in peace.
Seafaring, open up and see on the bay.
In case this investment doesn't pay off, I'm gonna skedaddle. Jet skedaddle, that is.
Seven's got to have given us disguises that will help. Luckily, pirate fashion sensibilities aren't a mixed bat.
But all our bats match, Brash.
No, I mean hoge poach, motley, ragtag. If we mismatch some colors, rip off the sleeves.
Pull on an eye patch, buckles and swash.
Surprise!
See you.
A stowaway?
Ah, there's an eye in my suitcase.
You can't spell suitcase with that one.
See, or what are you doing in our matched luggage?
I thought you could use me on the mission, you know. If the ship found itself lost in the eye of a storm.
Sea Orb, the ship is being taken over by pirates!
Newly, I can be a pirate. I'll be a pirate!
We need disguises, not your eyes.
Aw, come on. The more eyes it have, the better. Just ask a spider.
It's true.
See? I've got a point.
No, you don't. You're a spear. Spears don't have points. With all the eye patches pirates wear, we'd have an easier time blending in with fewer eyeballs. I just don't see how a giant floating one will give us a leg up in this situation.
Sea Orb doesn't even have legs.
So, plenty of pirates are missing legs. They've got pig legs.
Bend on. I got an idea.
Keep walking, yar! No one's gonna drop in the sky and save ye!
Okay, Sea Orb, this should do it. How's that?
Well, something's not right because now I can't see.
Oh, sorry.
Ah, that's much
better. What do you think, Brash?
Is Sea Orb supposed to be a pirate or an ice cream cone?
You do have a scuba chocolate chip vibe going on.
At least it seems like Willy Nilly is the only pirate who's a ghost.
Yeah. Otherwise, Sea Orb would need to be mint chocolate chip.
Looks are only half of what being a pirate is all about. You gotta sound like one, too. Yarr. Ahoy, me hearties. Shiver me timberland. Dead men have no tails. X spots the mark.
Oh, speaking of spots and marks.
Markers?
All right, you lot. Get in these quarters.
What are you three lambards up to in here?
We were looking for booty, you scabby sea bass.
Harsh. I was just asking. Anyway, this be the last of the passengers to lock up. Captain Willy wants us back aboard on the Salty Piranha.
Sorry about the sorry about this.
If you get bored, there are some comics under that pillow. What? I never travel without something to read.
Such polite pirates. Dang it, I've already read this issue.
It's clear these pirates attacked the first cruise ship, and one wasn't enough. Whatever they did with the sea dunes, they're probably gonna do the same with the sea dunes the second, too.
Second, too?
If we can figure out what that is, we might just be able to save everyone from boof cruises. Could they be building a pirate fleet, stripping the boats for parts, or running an illegal regatta?
Regatta? Like the cheese used in cannoli filling?
That's regatta. A regatta is a boat race.
Aww, I'd love a cannoli right now.
Focus, Mango.
Remember, you're undercover. We're no longer private eyes, we're pirate eyes. Especially you, Sea Orb.
Ahoy there!
Yarr! Avast, you matey!
Don't you me, Avast?
Really? I thought it was a blast, like, hey, this is fun! We're having a blast!
No, it's a blast because we blast cannons.
No, I'm pretty sure it's Avast.
Avast what? Like, a vast number of things or a vast difference in opinion?
No, not Avast. Avast, like, one word.
A vast ocean to explore.
Avast means stop! As in, avast your antics, you blathering buccaneers! Mr. Ed, report!
Here be the passenger list, dread Captain Pirate, sir. I've checked it twice.
Time to see who's nautical or nice. Get it?
good one, sir.
By my count, there'll be 11 souls missing.
11?
8 of them are part of the cruise crew. Oh, wait. There's actually one gal with 8 jobs.
So, it's 4 souls missing?
1 crew member, 2 passengers, and that billionaire feller.
$1 billion escaped from the middle.
He could be hiding.
And... what of the 2 passengers?
Yarr, there were 2 gator folk what I spotted earlier that no one see twixt then and now.
They will have to triple check the cruise ship on the way. Don't forget my piracy policy.
Now, survivors?
Right. What? No! The opposite of that. Everyone survives. Until their time has come. Especially $1 billion. Plot a course for the island. Edmund, join me eastern.
We sail the ocean blue.
You heard the captain, you scurvy dumbos.
I don't have scurvy. My fur is naturally yellow.
Batten down the hatches. Secure our cargo.
Cargo? I think he means bogo.
You too. Swab the deck. Here.
Gee, being a pirate janitor is hard work.
Willy-nilly knew exactly who that pirate meant when he mentioned a billionaire.
Even a ghost pirate can't resist the siren crawl of a billionaire's booty.
Well, let's just hope Bill's booty stays quiet so they don't find him, wherever he's hiding. Something tells me this willy-nilly was hoping to capture Bill and Dawes in particular. But why? And how would a ghost know he was on board anyway? Were the pirates looking for Dawes when they attacked the other crews?
We've got bigger fish to fry, Brash. If we can find out the name of this island we're heading to, we can call the Coast Guard and have them meet us there.
And maybe it's not too late to save the passengers of the first sea dunes. Let's get snooping.
Be careful, guys. The pirates are also looking for 2 alligator passengers.
You don't exactly blend in either, Sea Orb. You should just stay out of sight.
The name Sea Orb, and sight is what I'm best at.
Fine. Go see if you can get one of these pirates to talk.
Squirt! Polly water cracker!
Crocodile!
Relax, Brash. I'm sorry I ever dredged Duro's name back up. But forget getting this crew to talk. I'll get them to sing. by singing. Pirates do love a good sea shanty. What's the name of this pod-ridden island? What will we do when we get to the pilot? My favorite salad dressing is befalls it island. Early in the morning. Ahoy, here be knowing the way how we be going.
We're heading to land just like it was planned.
The ship shan't be slowing while the winds are blowing.
But won't someone tell me why we're on the high sea? Ahoy, here be knowing the way how we be going.
We're heading to land just like it was planned.
The ship shan't be slowing while the winds are blowing.
But won't someone tell me why we're on the high sea?
Who's in this high sea?
Mango interrogates with the shanty. Will he get answers, can or can't he? But dancing the jig and singing a tune doesn't explain what the pirates are doing. Mango interrogates with the shanty. Will he get answers, can or can't he? But dancing the jig and singing a tune doesn't explain what the pirates are doing.
The ship is going somewhere, but this is getting us nowhere.
Sea orbs sure making a splash, though.
Yeah. So while all the pirates are distracted, we can go right to the source. Willy-nilly is up on the poop deck.
Heh. Poop deck? Well, hang on. Why's the bathroom called the head? Shouldn't that be the poop deck?
Because the toilet was traditionally at the front, or the head, of a ship. The poop deck is in the rear.
Well, duh. It's in the rear. That part makes sense. For a poop deck, it doesn't smell poopy.
Goes down.
Mango, is the pirate who saw us before we were in disguise?
It'll lay the pirate talk on sick, Brash.
We'd be hard to tire with the carpin.
Arr, nobody talks to willy-nilly when he be doing this Captain Lee duties up on the poop deck.
What about A?
Did you just say, what a butthead?
What? No. Did your eye patch out of your ears?
Oh, whoops. Thanks. How embarrassing. Arr, while you're at it, do I have any spinach in me teeth?
No, you're good.
Now, remind me. What do we plan to do with these passengers, seeing we hijacked this ship, R?
Don't you remember? Wait a minute. I'm beginning to think you're not part of this pirate crew.
What? Of course we are!
Then answer them more of these riddles. Four. First riddle. What does a pirate do after eating beans?
Sar?
Are correct. Second riddle. What is a pirate's favorite subject in school?
Pardon.
Are correct. That was an easy one. Riddle the third. What is a pirate's least favorite color?
Maroon.
Are correct. Almost threw you for a loop there. Final riddle. What is a pirate's favorite letter of the alphabet?
I got this. R.
Nar. Incorrect. Tish the sea. Blow me down. You be the gators will go on missing. All hands on deck. And by deck I mean then. Show these carharans the ropes.
This rope's called a halyard.
That one there's a downfall.
And this rope keeps me pants on.
I mean, tie him up, you rapscallions.
I saw the rapscallion once. He opened for DJ Discount.
The writer is Von Hunt. Yeah. The Creon, yeah. The writer is Von Hunt. Yeah.
Y'all not getting loose from this.
Arr. What are we gonna do with these sly boots?
I say we kill him.
Keel haul 'em, that is.
Yay!
I say we stop 'em, then we keel haul 'em.
Yay!
I say we let 'em go.
Yay!
Arr, let's make 'em walk the plank.
No, remember Willy Nilly's piracy policy? He wants all the passengers kept alive. Willy Nilly needs every single passenger for whatever he be planning on that island without these two.
Without us? We will walk the plank.
Boladron.
We're amphibious.
All right.
This is more like hopping the plank.
Where'd they go?
It's too dark. Do you see him in the waves?
Me? Or no? I not wearing my glasses, so everything looks wavy.
Confound it! Willie's gonna be Willie disappointed.
Get back to searching the sea dunes the second. There still be Bill and Dallas and the one crew member to find.
Just like the sea monkey bars.
Why'd we jump ship?
I had to make a rash decision.
You mean a brash decision? How are we gonna save anyone if we can barely save ourselves?
Mango, you heard the pirate. Willy Nilly needs every single passenger for who knows what. Without us, his numbers won't add up.
Giving us time to figure out what Willy Nilly's mysterious plan is and find a way to stop it. But how? You don't even know where the pirates are going.
We can track that pirate ship via Sea Orb's built-in tracking device. So long as Sea Orb stays on aboard it, that is. I should be getting the signal any second now. And any second now. Any second now. Any second now.
10 hours later.
Think or swim. That's what I always say. But since I'm tired of swimming, it's a good thing 7 path is best with these balloons. My skin was drying out from the salty ocean water. It's not like the rivers and the lakes that I'm used to.
Dang it. I'm still not getting a signal. There must be some sort of interference or something.
I'm telling you, we're on the Bermuda Triangle.
It's Bermuda, and we're nowhere near it.
If we're lost, then how do you know? Brash, there seems to be a shark circling us. Hello? Excuse me?
Oh, stay there.
Can you tell us where we are?
Where you are? I don't even know where I am. I'm just aimlessly going around in struggles.
I can relate. We were treading water all night, but it feels like longer. Nice to ask someone else to talk to. Hey, where are you going? Yikes! The salty piranhas come back to finish us off!
No! This is a different pirate ship!
More pirates? What fun on Plata Road is gonna be this chunk? Cappy Hook?
No! Not Captain Hook! Captain Hook mine!
And Slaker! Slaker!
It's Bill Plungerman!
Ahoy, Mango and Brash! Let 'em down, me hearties!
We haven't seen Houston's off the hook!
Thanks for letting us off these hooks, by the way.
Everyone's been asking when you turn up again.
We're back by Sandman.
And you're a pirate now?
Aye, 'tis true. The last time we met, I, Dill Plungerman, had gained control over my snake arm, Slinker. Listen to me! But, as it turned out, what is best for me is to share some of that control with my shiny, slithery counterpart.
And what's best for me is to do the same in return.
Maybe we can cooperate? By covering one eye each, neither of us has the dominant personality.
Allowing us to function as a codependent organism.
After the eye patches, Going full pirate seemed like the next logical step.
But we're not like evil pirate. We're more of a morally gray Robin Hood type of pirate. Arr.
Speaking of eye-opening experiences, glad to see you've recovered from that mysterious coma, Brash.
Thanks, Biller. Goodbye.
Cun, let me introduce you to the motley crew of the Plum Tart.
Call me Mockweez. Arr.
God comfort pre at your service. Arr.
I'm Tasha. Arr. That's a Borum up in the bro's nest.
Don't you mean crow's nest?
Nah, bro. Yo-ho, bro.
And this here is our quartermaster, Montague Baggy Wrinkles.
That's a Thinkus.
Yeah, a fighting Thinkus.
Trust me, you do not want to race that Thinkus in a sword fight.
So, tell me, what are you two investigators doing out here on a balloon raft in the middle of the Bermuda Triangle?
See? I told you.
We were investigating a missing cruise ship when the one we were on was attacked by the dread pirate ghost, willy-nilly.
Willy-nilly?
You heard of him?
Legend has it, a fearsome pirate by the name of willy-nilly plundered a secret island of its sacred treasure. Like all ill-begotten riches, it came with a hefty price. Nilly was cursed to pay back the debt by delivering 1,000 souls to the island before 300 years passed. If he failed, his stolen fortune would disappear forever. But he didn't care. He just said, eh, I got plenty of time. So, the tale goes, anyway.
How long ago was that?
What time is it? Oh, exactly 300 years ago comes sundown.
Brash, that's why willy-nilly meets all the passengers. He's finally gotten around to paying back the debt so he can keep his fortune.
Okay, but why? It's not like he can use it for anything. He's a dead ghost. And that still doesn't explain why he's after Bill and Dallas.
Of the Dallas discount stores?
The very same.
Land foe, bro.
Land? We're nowhere near shore.
Sorry, I meant jet ski, ho, bro.
Drat. Discount gas doesn't go as far as it used to. Eep! What's down faster? You again?
What a coincidence. Bill and Dallas.
Wait, if you're here, then you're not on the cruise, which means there aren't enough,
Enough, what?
Oh, nothing.
We got a few questions for you, Dill.
Who, me?
No, that Bill.
Gee, this sure are a lot of bills in this book. Myself, Bill and Dallas, this overdue phone bill I have to pay, and willy-nilly.
Sure right. Willy is a nickname for William, just like Bill is.
Yes, but Willy and Dallas doesn't sound like Billy and Dallas.
Hang on. If Willy is short for William, the Nilly must be short for Nillian.
So, the Dread Pirate Ghost's full name is William Nillian. So what?
Dallas great however many greats grandfather's last name was Nillian. Bill and Dallas is William Million Dallas.
He's willy-nilly's hair! Which means your inheritance and fortune began with the cursed treasure he stole centuries ago. And that's the debt you have to settle. The family debt. So, are you working for Willy, or is Willy working for you?
Talk, you slimy sea slug, you little liver scallywag, you briny blind rat.
Very piratey. Don't forget to throw in a few R's and yars.
All right. Arr.
Whoop, an albatross!
Ooh, where?
Hey, how's it going?
You're not going anywhere!
You can't do this to me! I'm rich!
First your name's Bill, then it's William, now it's Richard. Make up your mind!
Give him the Davy Jones workout, then send him to the locker room!
You wouldn't! I'll believe you!
Well, make a daydream believer out of you.
Alright, I'll top. When I was a kid, my mother told me stories of my distant ancestor,
William Newyum, whereas he was known on the Seven Seas, the dread pirate Willie Newyum.
Yeah, he stole a cursed treasure, blah blah blah, we got that part already.
When Willie retired from piracy, he had a family and started a business with the Borough Bounty.
A shave and a powdered wig and I'm a respectable businessman.
The wealth grown from that treasure was passed down generation to generation, along with the legend. It was said that if no heir was paid that the debt in time, the ghost of Willie Newy would come to claim it himself. It didn't matter then if the curse was even real or not. Payment wouldn't be due in their lifetimes. Pass the buck. That would be the burden of whoever inherited the fortune when the 300 years are up. Me! I hoped it was all just a fanciful bedtime story, something my mom made up to get me to behave. She would always say, be good or Willie will get you. But now I know the curse is real, and if the times aren't met, I'll lose everything I ever earned. Every dime, every dollar. It can all be traced back to that centuries-old cursed treasure. I inherited 999,999,909. My business savvy turned it into a $1 billion empire.
What? That means you've only made $10.
Exactly. My business savvy is terrible. If this fortune disappears, I'll never be rich again.
That's why you bought the cruise line in the first place. Not to make money, but so Willie Nilly could have an easy time finding...
Souls. I was right. Bill and Dollars is literally collecting souls.
The ghost did all the collector. I merely offer people the vacation of a lifetime.
Yet when DeSoto washed up, Spotty, Willie Nilly, instead of putting a stop to all this, you sent another cruise full of victims for him.
What do you think is going to happen to everyone Willie Nilly takes to this island? They just what? Starve?
Surely it has a beach. They can eat all the sandwiches there.
Pirate ghost,
sandwich
now
is there.
Sandwiches?
Seriously?
What's next?
What's next is that we're going to save everyone. Where is this island $10 bill?
Collarbone Cove.
Collarbone Cove?
You heard of it?
Never heard of it.
It's just below Skull Island, above Spine Inlet, flanked by Red Lagoon, across from Funny Bone Bay.
Big start the tart, you motley crew. Make full sail for Collarbone Cove.
I sure hope Sea Horses is coming.
Try the blue line on the endless sea. There's a ship that's sailing. In that ship, this one free. Pirates gather, send sail the destiny
underneath the stars of pride.
Who's the flag and sour night?
On this cruise, I share the light.
All tied up,
we'll set and sail.
Pirates go,
we never fail.
Ocean.
We breathe in the storm, we ride again.
This one last time. Do you have any freaks?
Goldfish.
Arr, darn these cards. Huh? Arr, a ship's ahoy.
Ooh, did someone mention cookies?
Mango and Brash.
Mango and Brash? I'm not familiar with that pirate phrase.
I suppose the vitamin C in mangoes will help fight off the scurvy.
It's them gator traders. They joined another pirate crew.
Arr, when the spring upon her cable.
Now that sounds piratey. What's it mean?
Arr, what a mine and start to PDR? Let's just give him some payback.
Yarr! Yarr's revenge!
Heave home, me parties!
And remember, we got a co-worker aboard that ship.
Can you repeat that again, Empirate?
She be meaning a twiddle matey. Arr!
Alright. Mr. Mockweez, wipe her nose!
You mean send her a shot across her bow?
Look, I'm now all caught up with the Paraninga.
There she blows. As in she'll blow us out of the water with them cannons.
And what do we got? Pea shooters?
You got me. Cannonball!
Let me die!
Now's your chance.
Oh, dang. They all got back up pretty fast.
We got Yasar around it, especially the raw one.
Care to coin any more pirate phrases?
You're looking for coins? Then get a load of these pieces of bait.
3, 2, 1, go!
Disarm me!
So sorry!
We surrender!
Thanks for lending a hand, Jor. All 8 for 7 of them.
Day you come back and risk your own necks to save all these folks made me realize how wronged I've been, only looking out for myself all these years.
I'm glad we were able to inspire you with an opportunity for personal growth.
And presumably the regrowth of your art. All right, you lot. Where are the sea dunes? What do you do with all the passengers?
Willie only hired us to bring them here, and that's all we did.
And you didn't wonder what a ghost was gonna do with the people?
Hey, pirate work is hard to get.
Well, where am Willie now?
Captain Nilly took all the prisoners onto the island himself.
Is that what happened, Seaor?
Look. Despite being a literal giant eyeball, occasionally there are some things I miss, all right?
It's true. I saw willy-nilly order all the pirates to stay behind on this ship. I would have followed, but I get non-motion sickness. I don't like to be grounded.
What? You'll never find Willie's secret volcanic lair deep within the lost coal with the color bone coal.
Arr, especially not without this treasure map that leads directly to it.
Give me that!
Let's go, Gators. There's no maritime to waste.
Upline and Sleeker, keep your eyes on these Maggy mercenaries.
Aye!
See if you can get a message to the Coast Guard.
You're coming with us, Dallas. We only have till sundown to get everyone off the spotlight, or who knows what your Grandpa Way will do to them. Now, round now, you're about...
You don't need me for this. I'm sure you'll be enough for Willie, able to convince Willie...
Quiet, you!
This way!
Investigators borrowing a map, hoping they don't fall into a trap. This book is full of piratey action. Once again, Angus found a distraction. Investigators borrowing a map, hoping they don't fall into a trap. This book is full of piratey action. Once again, Angus found a distraction.
Down there!
Still missing.
Willy-nilly! What have you done with all the passengers?
Why, I claim their souls by tossing them into the spiry pit of lava!
What? You knew about this part, didn't you, Bill?
I assumed there'd be something like that.
Yes, and now to officially complete the terms of the curse, you, Bill and Dallas, my progeny, my heir, must sign this contract, confirming you deliver 1,000 souls to the doom. An orderly rest, knowing the family fortune is secure.
I'll recall a contract as part of the curse.
And the tale's been passed down over several generations. Some of the finer details may have been left out in the telling.
So I signed that, and all my wealth won't suddenly disappear?
You'll be rich forever!
And you're certain about the tally, right? By my count, we're a couple souls short.
Well, sign first, then toss those two souls into the pit. Surely that floating eyeball has a soul.
Well, I'm a robot, so I don't know about soul, but I do have rhythm.
Wait, where's Branko?
And if I don't, sire?
Then you give up your entire fortune. But in return, I suppose I could bring a reclaimed soul back to life.
Really? You can just do that?
Sure, why not? Magic ghost powers are totally a thing.
I never give up. I already sent some 990-some-odd souls to their deaths. What's one or two more?
Don't do this, Bill. Think about your own soul.
If I can't save $5 billion, then there's absolutely no point in saving $1 billion.
That's right. Sign the contract. X marks the spot.
I'm there.
Where? Mango!
You stole your special scuttermuck grants.
Give him five. Kingland slain him.
You fool. Without signing that contract, my generations of wealth would disappear. If I'm not rich, what do I even have left to live for?
Then to the priming deep with him, Julia.
No, I tell you back. I take an elder.
Mango, you just brutally killed the man by kicking him in a pout lava. And willy-nilly said he could. Wait a second.
Bomboyas, maybe.
Make him score full pot I writ.
Bottoms up.
Oh.
Long no one. Rob
this
inside.
Is the
look out for Lamo.
I'm alive! I'm alive!
And so is everyone else. All the passengers.
So is there like a Mrs. Sardine?
What the whole other side of the island is a resort?
Mango, how did you know?
When we were following that map, I knew I heard the song, Your Song Vang, DJ Discom's version. So I followed the sound and saw that. The stairs led me right back to you. Now let's see who this bony dread pirate willy-nilly really is.
You mean, he's not a ghost?
No, this is so I'm trying to hornswoggle dollars out of this family fortune.
Right, I knew that ghosts aren't real.
Dollars great whenever grandfather is actually...
Captain DeSoto?
Yeah. This is bigger than stealing his fortune. This was about exposing Bill and Dallas as the cruel and ruthless pirate he truly is. Can block my cruise line just so he can send 1,000 people to their deaths over a superstition.
This is all a big misunderstanding. Look, everyone's perfectly fine.
That isn't changed the fact that you believe you are sacrificing all these people.
You can't prove that.
That's what the contract was. A confession.
Well, I'll never sign it now.
You don't really have to.
I already sent some 990-some-odd souls to their deaths. What's one or two more? Already sent some 990-some-odd souls to their deaths. To their deaths. To their deaths. I already sent some 990-some-odd souls to
their
deaths.
See? I knew I'd be useful on this mission.
What's one or two more?
So, Captain DeSoto, you hired pirates to attack the sea dunes and bring all the passengers to this island?
You then came back in the life raft mumbling, willy-nilly, to see if Dallas would take the bait and send out more souls to be claimed by the ghost.
How did you even pull this off, DeSoto? The only person outside of my family who knows my million lineage is...
me! Edmund Schmidtlap at your service.
Schmidtlap? Your first name
now
is Edmund?
Now that was a good pirate disguise.
For years, Mr. Dollison's paid people a pittance while he pillaged with the prophets.
How to get
his
souls.
His plundering only got worse as his preoccupation with this pirate prophecy progressed. Sorry about all the P words. I've just been holding this in for so long. I secretly relocated company funds to build this resort. So once everyone got here, they'd be safe and sound. And have a good time, too.
Remember, you saw, we're just building on this side of the island.
But we couldn't let anyone know the attacks were all an elaborate ruse.
If Dallas found out, our efforts to expose her for the cuffs while he is would be sick.
Hence why you even kept the rent-a-pirates in the dark, so they wouldn't tark.
As the saying goes, loose sips make ships, Seuss lips stink hips.
Once the pirates brought each cruise to the island, I took the passengers ashore and made sure everyone was accounted for sure.
Welcome to Collarbone Cove! I hope you enjoy your Calamari live action real pirates experience!
A free upgrade? Awesome!
Those pirates were so lifelike. Animatronics are amazing these days.
Not a single soul was harmed. That's my piracy policy. And we wouldn't be here if Bill and Dallas followed the same code.
You're getting a little carried away with the message acting. I like it.
Well, your plan to reveal Bill was willing to kill for money worked. But it wasn't exactly a watertight plot.
Tell that to the writer.
You two are off the hook for all this trouble you caused.
Speaking of off the hook, here comes Hook, Line, and Slinker.
And the coast one.
We finally pin our phone down and were able to get a signal through.
Gee, we should have arrested those two fellas back on page 3.
But without us, these gators wouldn't have caught the real baddie, Dill and Dallas.
Investigators, this is my brother-in-law, Scott.
Sasquatch. Hey, you do have big feet, especially for a squash.
Hello, gators. Butternut McGee let me tackle one.
7.
Bajor.
This isn't much of an olive branch, but can I lend you a hand?
I'm sorry, Jor.
I'm sorry too, 7. Hey, I do disclosure cure my non-motion sickness.
Won't you look at that? We saved the Melio Bonds and a 1,000 cruise goers.
What do you mean? I've been safe at this island resort the whole time. The only thing that died was my phone battery.
Gustavo, head scientist.
Hello, Mango and Brass.
You know, for a minute there, I was convinced my former partner, Daryl, had come back as a ghost, and he'd hijack your cruise to get you two to bake some science that will return unto his corporeal form. But that's just silly.
Nothing silly about science. Odds are, a bit of Daryl still exists in the world somewhere.
There could even be a box of... out there that have yet to come to life.
Well, the sun is about to set. Whether that curse is real or not, Dallas' fortune will disappear anyway once word gets out about his evil business practices. I hope this phony willy-nilly nonsense has taught us not to buy into tall tales.
Yep, no more supernatural speculations from us. From here on out, we're gonna stick to the facts and...
What's that rumbling?
Is that...
the actual ghost of willy-nilly?
The real treasure was the friends you made along the way.
Are you kidding me?
Come on, Brash. Let's join the fun.
Our daughter was set sail. Pirates bold,
we never bailed.
On the ocean,
we prevailed.
On the storm, we ride again. On this vessel, made of dreams. Adventure cross. Well, so it seems. Treasure's hidden in the moon. Mom Lynch, the youth. Pirates laughing in the mummies.
Underneath the stars of black.
Was the flag a sour knot?
On the schools I should share the love.
All tied up with sad
sail.
Pirates full.